In this video, we're going to talk about complex eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And we'll start with an example. Let's take a look at the matrix 2, 1, negative 1, 2. So does that have any eigenvalues and eigenvectors? And if you think about how this acts in the plane, you might think the answer would be no. Because what this matrix does is it sends 1, 0 to 2, 1, and it sends 0, 1 to negative 1, 2. Now here's a picture of that. It sends 1, 0 to 2, 1, and 0, 1 to negative 1, 2. So what it seems to be doing is it seems to be rotating by this angle, the arctangent of a half, and stretching by this length, which is root 5. So if it stretches and rotates, no matter what vector you start out with, you start out with a vector here, it's going to rotate it, and you're not going to get a multiple of that vector. You start out with a vector here, it's going to rotate it. You're going to get something that's not a multiple of that vector. No matter what vector in R2 you pick, AX cannot possibly be parallel to X. So it would seem that the matrix doesn't have any eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Except that's not quite right. It doesn't have any eigenvectors in R2. It doesn't have any real eigenvectors. But suppose we look at vectors that aren't in R2, but instead are in C2. What happens if we feed it vectors which have complex components? And in fact, we discover that if you feed it the vector 1i, you multiply it out, 2 negative 1, 1, 2 times i1, I said 1i, I meant i1, gives us 2i minus 1 and 2 plus i. And 2i minus 1 is I times 2 plus i, and this is 1 times 2 plus i. So the whole thing gives us 2 plus i times i1. In other words, i1 is an i. This is a complex eigenvector, and that's the complex eigenvalue. And likewise, if you look at negative i1, then that's also an eigenvector, only now the eigenvalue is 2 minus I rather than 2 plus I. So the upshot is that there are no real eigenvalues or eigenvectors to this matrix, but there are complex eigenvalues, namely 2 plus or minus I, and there are complex eigenvectors, namely plus or minus I, 1. Two eigenvalues, two eigenvectors, that's what you'd expect from a 2x2 matrix. Now, the way that you find complex eigenvalues is the same as the way that you find real eigenvalues. You compute the characteristic polynomial, and then the eigenvalues are the roots of the polynomial. The real eigenvalues are the real roots. The complex eigenvalues are the complex roots. So let's see how that works for the matrix we've been looking at. You take lambda times identity minus that matrix and get lambda minus 2, 0 minus negative 1, 0 minus 1, lambda minus 2. And then you take the determinant of that matrix, and you get lambda minus 2 times lambda minus 2 minus 1 times negative 1. In other words, lambda minus 2 squared plus 1. And if you expand that out, that's lambda squared minus 4 lambda plus 5. Now, if you want to find the roots of this, you can get it from here, or you can just use the quadratic formula. And you get minus b plus or minus b squared minus 4ac over 2a. But 4ac is 20. That's bigger than b squared. And we say that doesn't matter. We get 4 plus or minus the square root of negative 4 over 2. Square root of negative 4 is 2i. So we get 4 plus or minus 2i over 2. And that's 2 plus or minus i. Bingo. We got our eigenvalues. Same method as always. How about eigenvectors? Well, we also use the same method as always. We take the matrix minus lambda I, or if you prefer, you can take lambda I minus the matrix. Doesn't matter. They're just negatives of each other. And you row reduce them to find a basis for the null space. In this case, this is A minus 2 plus I times the identity. And if you multiply the top row by I, negative I times I is 1. Negative 1 times I is I. Is minus I, and then subtract the first row from the second, Bingo! You got yourself the reduced row echelon form. And we're looking for the null space, so each row gives you an equation. x1 minus ix2 equals 0. In other words, x1 is ix2. And of course, x2 is itself. So our vector is a multiple of i1. That's how you get the eigenvectors. Just like with real eigenvalues, you want to take the a minus lambda I, row reduce it, and find a basis for the null space. Okay. So in summary, you already know that real polynomials can have complex roots, and real matrices can have complex eigenvalues and eigenvectors, because the real matrix will have a real polynomial as its characteristic polynomial, and that polynomial may or may not have complex roots. Nothing wrong with complex eigenvalues. Since it's a real polynomial, the roots come in complex conjugate pairs. So the complex eigenvalues of a real matrix come in complex conjugate pairs. And the complex eigenvectors also come in complex conjugate pairs. In the next video, we're going to see how these two pairs, you look at the real and imaginary parts, and that gives us a plane where something interesting has happened. And we'll examine the real geometry of complex eigenvectors.